So today's video is a little bit different. Today I'm not building something that I thought of. I've actually went out and got, well, I ordered them. I got some short circuit electronic hobby kits from Jayco. So these are actually pretty cool. So they come with, there's three different like levels. So blue is base, no, blue is the second volume, it says on here. So, and then green is the last one. I actually have the green book here. So they have, there's all different things that you can make. There's like car alarms and intercoms and countdown timers, touch switches, bionic ears. Yeah, so today I'm going to be building. So I'm going to go from the lowest to the highest. So today is the countdown timer because it's project two. And then the next one will be project five, which is the touch switch. So let me move these out of the way. And let's open this. So, as I said, this one is a countdown timer. So they have, so they don't actually come with instructions, but they do mark out everything on the PCB, so you can basically just figure out where everything goes. That's how I do them if I don't have the book. So yeah, it says instructions not included. So yeah, these aren't instructions, these just have like other things, and they have all the books here. So volume 1, volume 2, volume 3, and it has a list of all the components and stuff. So I'll get rid of these, none of that's needed, and we can start by opening this. So this is, and I also got 2 9-volt batteries because three of these circuits run on 9-volt batteries, but the intercom runs on 12 volts, but that's right. So here we have the relay. If I can get it out of this plastic. Okay, so we have a relay. DC 6 volts, 5 amps, 125 volts AC. If you're interested in that. Oh, okay. I guess this is gonna open. So here we have some sort of coil. I never know what these are for, but you don't really need them because I actually have built. Before I had this channel, two other circuits. So this is a electronic eye. So basically, this shines into this light-dependent resistor, and then if the beam gets broken, it sets off this like an alarm. And then this one is a siren, which I can show you. So, and the lights flash as well. So yeah, that's them, but let's get back to today's project. So yeah, it actually says where everything goes. So it's not really that hard to build this thing. I don't really know what this thing is, but I guess we'll figure it out. Have some diodes, a button. Guess to set the time, capacitor, microchip. Let's open this next. Actually, I have scissors, so I'm gonna just use these. Okay, we'll tip all this stuff out. So here we have like a potentiometer, a couple resistors, and then at first I actually just scrapped these poles because I didn't really know what they were for on the other ones. I thought they might have been like standoffs. But turns out they actually don't really. Well, they didn't matter on these ones because the speakers are stuck together. Because, like I just soldered the wires straight into them. Now I have to make sure they get all the components off this. But, yeah, I thought they might have been like standoffs because these have little holes, but nope. Apparently, we get the folder. Yeah, so they actually go like on the terminals so that you can solder wires onto them if you don't have things permanently connected to the relay, which is pretty nice. So they have three for the relay and then two for the 9-volt. I might not use them. I'm not too sure. But yeah, this coil, I really have no clue what it's for. You might say on the picture. Nope. So I guess then I'll just put that in the bin with all the others from, oh, this is anti-static foam, like bubble wrap foam kind of stuff. It's the best. So you want to start off with the resistors mostly because you will, if you don't, it will, like if you put in the relay and stuff first, like this, and then you put in your capacitor, it's gonna take up a lot of space. And then you might not be able to like stick the little components in. So yeah. Don't really know what that stuff's for. Oh, this is for the button. This is relay. Alright, well, we only have four resistors. So let's check that our soldering iron has heated up. Get my solder reel. If you want to learn how to solder, I have a video on that. So yeah, that's heated and ready to go. So just gonna get my multimeter because it's a quick way of identifying what your resistors are. I'm just gonna get two alligator clips here and hook them onto my probes so that I can quickly just do this. So this one looks to be, Jesus, sorry about that. This one seems to be the 820. So let's put this one edge at the back so it doesn't fall out. And this one is, see here, this one looks to be, actually, okay, hold on, let me figure out what value this is. This and as you can see, I figured them out. Now I will put in the LED. So the A is the long leg, the K is the short leg. They go in just like so. In fact, I'm going to solder the resistors in. That's the first thing I do. So I'm gonna grab my helping hand here. Take off the magnifying glass that I don't need. Hold the PCB. Get my solder iron. Heat up pad. Solder into it. Okay. So now that that's done, going to put in this thing. Actually, I'll put the diode in first. So the two diodes right here. Okay, so one goes right here, and make sure that the line here matches with your line on your diode, so that can go there. Okay, so next, I think... I'll install the transistor. Is this a transistor or a power regulator? I don't really know. Okay, so that's in. There's only one of them. So I'll solder that on. Okay. Hope those two things aren't touching. Let me just see here. They do appear to be touching. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go to a flathead screwdriver, stick that in the middle. I'm gonna just desolder that. Okay, so now this shouldn't be touching. Hopefully. So let's just shut these off. So I actually accidentally cut them together, so now I have to pull them apart and cut them separately. Okay. I'm actually gonna move these pins over there. Okay. So next, I'm going to do the little LED. Like so. Let's put this on. Okay. Off. All right, so now I will install the button. I'm not really sure which way it goes. See if I can see on the picture. Okay, so the face is up. So like that, okay. So let's just put this in. It's a bit hard. The holes aren't actually the size of a button, so you have to make them the right size. Good enough. Good. Okay. So now that that's in place, let's solder this thing on. I would say it goes this way. Oh, so that's how you set the time. Okay. What should we do? Yeah, I think we'll do the micro control thing first. Should I go this way? So let's put all the pins into one hole. So I'm gonna have to squish these in a bit more. Finally. Okay. So now I should have to put solder. When you're soldering big ones like this, put solder on the diagonals and then go down. So the next thing is this, I guess. This is a 1 mega ohm potentiometer or pot. Okay, so now, basically it's just a relay. So put that on there. Of course one pin doesn't fit. Actually, I'm gonna install the post first. So let's put this in here. See if we can somehow hold this and then solder it. Because I don't really want to hold the metal while it's being heated up by a soldering iron. Okay, that was good. Put that in. Okay, next one. Here. Just annoying. Let's put this under there. Okay, finally. Just do that. Last one for this. For the relay. Okay, and then I will do the two. Actually, no, I won't do the two for the battery. I'll just solder the battery connector on. Show negative. Okay, so I don't really know what setting is what. I'm gonna say that that goes that way. Oh yeah, there we go. So that. A little bit. Should click off any second now. Okay, maybe not. it turns on. And it turns off. Pretty cool, eh? So, going to scrap these. Scrap the rest of the junk. Into the bin. Then, yeah. Okay, I'm gonna see how quick I can do this outro. Okay, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Hope you learned something new. I really do suggest doing, whatever. So, thanks for watching. I hope you liked the video. And if you want something new, if you're a beginner, I really do suggest these. And yeah, I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.